Welcome to Golden Software's video training for Voxler 4. Voxler is an affordable 3D well data and modeling software package that allows you to produce professional-looking graphics. In this video, I will demonstrate how to display your data as a scatter plot and edit the display properties. In this welcome dialog, you can open a new project or worksheet, begin importing data, open an existing project, or access the tutorial. We'll import a data file. From the welcome dialog, we can import a file by clicking the Import button in the New section on the left. Alternatively, if we had closed the welcome dialog, we could start this import process by clicking File, Import. In the Import dialog, we'll use the drop-down list in the bottom right corner to set the file type for your data file format. We'll be importing the mineralconcentration.dat sample file, so we'll set this to DAT Golden Software Data. Choose your file from the list of files with this extension and click Open. For certain data file formats, a Data Import Options dialog will appear next. This is where we can specify how the data is formatted. Our columns are properly defined, so we'll click OK to complete the import. The Data Source module appears in the Network Manager, so our import was successful. Now that the data has been imported, we need to verify that it is classified as point data so we can add a ScatterPlot module to it. And we need to verify that the appropriate columns have been set for each field. To do so, verify that the Data Source module is selected. On the General page in the Property Manager, verify that the output type in the Output section is set to points. If it is set to wells, click in the field to expand the drop-down list and select points. With the output type defined as points, the Property Manager shows a Worksheet Columns section. This section is where we set the XYZ columns, as well as the columns for any and all components we wish to import. By default, if you have columns labeled X, Y, and Z in your data file, Voxler picks these as the X coordinates, Y coordinates, and Z coordinates. This is the case here, so we don't need to change these. If Voxler cannot easily identify the X, Y, and Z columns from your header information, it automatically assigns columns A, B, and C to these three fields. Similarly, any columns in your data file that are not identified as x-coordinates, y-coordinates, or z-coordinates are loaded in as components. You can add or remove components by changing the number in the Component Columns field of the Components section. And you can specify which columns are defined as each component by selecting the desired column from the drop-down list for each numbered component. In the same way, in the Labels section, you can specify the number of columns available for use in labeling the scatterplot, and you can define which columns those are. We will leave the defaults. In the Worksheet Rows section, we can specify the header row, and we can define custom rows to plot if we do not wish to plot them all. Again, we will leave the defaults, which will use all of the data. If you can't easily recall from your column headers which columns to use, or you can't recall which rows you want to exclude from your plot, you can click the Edit Worksheet button in the section at the top to open the data in the worksheet view. From the worksheet, you can also edit the data and the changes will show immediately in your viewer window. Now that our data has been imported and all of our columns have been set, we can add the ScatterPlot module to our data to display the data as points in 3D space. To do so, with the Data Source module still selected in the Network Manager, either double-click on the ScatterPlot module in the Graphics Output folder of the Module Manager, or right-click on the Data Source module in the Network Manager and click Graphics Output, ScatterPlot. On the General page of the Property Manager, when the ScatterPlot module is selected in the Network Manager, you can set the method in the Classification section. The options are fixed or binning. When this method is set to binning, a binning field becomes available, next to which is an Edit Classes button. Clicking this Edit Classes button brings up the Edit Classes dialog, where we can define which component the bins are calculated for, whether to use equal bins or equal intervals for the binning method, and the number of classes the data is binned into. Double-clicking on a row in the table opens the Edit Symbol dialog, where you can define the symbol, color, and size. When the method is set to fixed, In the rendering section, you can set the geometric quality or resolution of the chosen symbol, the symbol itself, and the symbol size. You can also set the color method. There are three color method options: fixed, by color map, and by RGB. When the color method is set to fixed, all points are the same color. You can see the color just beneath the color method field. When the color method is set to by color map, you can define the color component used to determine the color for each point, and the color map to pull the colors from. When the color method is set to by RGB, you can specify whether the color range is the traditional 0 to 255 byte range or the 0.0 to 1.0 double range. And you can specify what components that you imported from the data file contain red, green, and blue color values. This data file doesn't contain RGB columns, but we can quickly add some to the data and the data source module for use here. Once we've added the appropriate data columns to the worksheet, they are immediately available to add to our data source module. Now that the color columns have been defined as components in the data source module, we can define these three columns as the color columns for our scatter plot. For both method options, you can choose to display all or a subset of the points in the density field in the top of the scatter plot section. And you can check the box next to Show Lines in the Rendering section to connect your scatterplot points with a line. On the Labels page in the Property Manager, you can choose to display labels from one of the data columns you defined as label columns, and you can edit the label properties. And from the Legend page, you can choose to display a legend if your method is binning or if your method is fixed, and your color method is by color map. You can edit the properties for the legend here as well. This concludes the ScatterPlot module tutorial. If you have any additional questions, please contact Golden Software.